Hey guys, Stephanie with AmericanMuscle.com here with an overview of the Mishimoto intercooler for the 2015 and up EcoBoost Mustang. In this video, we're gonna go over a few different things with the Mishimoto intercooler. We're gonna talk about the performance aspects of this intercooler, the materials and construction, and the install as well. I'm gonna go into more detail later, but I can tell you right now that this is a 1 out of 3 wrenches in the difficulty meter. The EcoBoost being a factory turbo car means that it's a great platform for modifications. The turbo functions great from the factory, but if you're looking for performance, the turbo and its setup have a lot more to give, and the front mount intercooler is an important piece to the turbo puzzle. The intercooler from Mishimoto is going to be an option for the EcoBoost owner looking to bring down intake air temps, as well as those looking for more performance and more boost. The whole purpose of an intercooler is to increase performance, and it does it through lowering the temperature of the incoming air that's compressed by the turbo. It forces cool air into the cylinders, so basically, we're looking at cooler intake air temps thanks to the intercooler. This makes it a good mod for stock cars that are worried about heat soak or modified cars that need some more cooling capability. The factory intercooler can only cool so much air. It's limited by its size, so when you start playing around with the EcoBoost and start running more boost and bolting on some mods, then you're looking at maxing out your factory unit and needing to upgrade. That being said, I wouldn't really peg a front mount as one of the best first performance upgrades, but it works best when you've already done some work and you want to make sure that your power potential isn't limited by your cooling setup. But like I just mentioned, depending on what area you're living in, and if your car is a daily, you could be having heat soak issues that are killing some of your performance, and so in that case, upgrading an intercooler is also a good idea. Just how much better of a cooling job an intercooler is capable of comes down to its size. This intercooler here is larger than the factory one all the way around, and that's one of the factors that's gonna help give you those cooler intake air temps. This intercooler has a 58% larger core with 25% more internal core volume and a big 165% increase in external fin surface area. So if we compare this to the factory front mount, the Mishi core is taller, thicker, and longer. This is an all the way around bigger intercooler than the factory one. The core is larger than the factory core is, but it's still going to work with the factory piping, which actually has 2 benefits to it, which I'll explain in a second, and it's still going to be a drop-in replacement. These are 2 very nice qualities because it means that you don't have to spend money on upgrading your piping, and you don't have to worry about having to modify anything to install this. And a larger core means that you have a larger cooling surface, hence the greater cooling capability. One thing to start thinking about when you start upgrading your setup around your turbo is things like pressure drop and turbo lag. So sometimes bigger isn't always better, depending on your setup and what all you've got going on. But with this intercooler, you aren't looking at a major pressure drop, which is good news for those of you that are concerned with your low-end power band. The ability of this front mount to do that has a lot to do with the fact that you're still using your factory piping, so that's the second benefit of keeping that piping. One other thing that I wanted to hit on when it comes to the factory piping is to keep in mind that these are speed density cars. They're not MAF cars, so you don't have to worry about needing a larger MAF housing or maxing out a housing since there's nothing to max out. When it comes to some specifics, this is of course TIG welded and it's made from 6061 aluminum. The aluminum is going to dissipate heat faster, which is why it's used for intercoolers. This guy's also got an in-tank diverter to divert and improve airflow, so you'll be able to utilize the entire front mount. Now this one is powder coated black, but Mishimoto does also offer the same intercooler in a polished finish if you're interested in that look instead. The black just gives a more stealthy appearance. As far as price, this intercooler is going to run you in between $500 and $600, but it is closer to the $500 mark. This is one of the more budget-friendly options, with only the SR offering being a lower price. Engine also offers an intercooler as well, and so does Cobb. So I wouldn't call the install for an intercooler on an S550 particularly difficult. It's going to take around 2 hours and be a 1 out of 3 wrenches in the difficulty meter. You are looking at needing a handful of tools, and a lift is going to be your best friend in this case. Getting the car up high enough to work under the front end will make things go faster for you. You'll be pulling the intercooler out from below the car, and you do have to pop off the front bumper cover, the grills, and pull the bottom dust cover off, but this is all easy stuff. Mishimoto does give some hardware for the install, and like I said earlier, this is a direct drop-in upgrade, so it's going to install the same way that the factory one comes out. Wrapping things up here, the Mishimoto intercooler is a drop-in front mount upgrade for the EcoBoost Mustang. Works with the factory piping, it doesn't cause a large drop in pressure over the factory unit, and on average, it provides a 35 degree drop in air intake temperature. It's an all-around larger intercooler, and I suggest you check it out more online right here at AmericanMuscle.com.